Hi, people. We back with another. Hey, yo, I just realized, like, right now that how stupid this chair looks with this new, like, nice computer desk that I got, like a gaming computer desk. And I still got this dumbass IKEA chair. Anyway, I don't know why I thought that was funny. Yeah, what was I saying? Another John Bellion reaction. Roll it. Welcome back to the channel, everybody. Channel's name is The Third Ernest. I'm Ernest Adiano III, y'all guys' third family. If you're new here and you're not subscribed and you like what you see at the end of the video, consider becoming part of the family, clicking the subscribe button, bottom right-hand corner. Now, John Bellion is definitely a he's a heavily requested artist on the channel, but he rarely puts out his own music, so I can't really, like, back before I went full-time on YouTube, I could never really react to it because new music kept on coming out and new music always takes precedence. But now that I'm full-time on YouTube, thanks to Patreon supporters, I can come at y'all with some more John Bellion reactions. And this specific reaction comes from a Patreon supporter who's at the tier that gets a request. And this is, oh, right here, Preoccupied John Bellion Aaron. Nah, I'm just kidding, Aaron. I'm sure you've seen the skit, and I'm sure that you're tired of people saying that, hey, have you seen that fucking Key and Peele skit, Aaron? But yo, for real, Aaron, I appreciate your Patreon membership, man, for being at the tier that allows you to get a request in. You know, I'm trying to get through them as fast as possible, but we're finally coming up on yours, and I really appreciate you being there because that allows me to stay full-time. Your contribution on Patreon, everybody is benefiting from it because it allows me to stay on YouTube for everybody. But that's all that I really got today. John Bellion is a multi-talented artist, so I really never know what the songs are gonna sound like until we listen. So let's go ahead and listen. Follow your boy on Instagram and on Twitter at The Third Ernest, just like the channel. The links are down in the description. And we got John Bellion, Preoccupied. Let's get it.
Wu-Tang raised me. Death cab changed me. You should go and ask Rihanna if the pen game's crazy. My artistry is everything. That's my baby. But when it comes to publishing, it's fuck you, pay me. Don't be mad because the records that you cut sound lazy.
Doc. Dude, bro, his shit is just like, it's so unique. It's so unique in like his own artistry and his what he has for his own sound compared to like what he can make for other artists and make like number one singles. Like he can do this very like very offbeat rap style and he does it really well, but he can also go and produce top 40 number one tracks. And it's dope how he acknowledges all these different genres within rap. Just in the first line alone, Wu-Tang raised me and Def Cab changed me, like Def Cab for a cutie, like the rock group, or the, it's not even rock, indie group, I guess you would call it. The fact that he listened to Wu-Tang and Def Cab, and then he wrote songs for Rihanna based off of that growing up. It's dope.
Be mad cause the records that you cut sound lazy. And everything I'm cooking sounding nuts like rabies. I hate rappers, please don't call me. Give me urinal suggestions like please don't stall me. Don't play for me.
Give me urinal suggestions like don't stall me. Like please don't stall me, but also urinal suggestions like your suggestions are piss poor, but also you piss in a urinal, which is called a stall. Fire. And everything I'm cooking sounds nuts like rabies. Like literally you go crazy whenever you have a case of rabies, like a rabid dog, but also nuts like squirrels. Like squirrels are known, like they are one of the main species that contracts rabies.
Please don't stall me. Don't play for me. I'll be yawning. How I'm doing pop melodies and you sound corny. Now everybody trying to hang around.
How am I doing the pop melodies? How am I the one writing this shit, but you're the one that sounds corny? Cause you're the one that's trying to fake it when really this is just me. This is who I am.
Doing pop melodies and you sound corny. Now everybody trying to hang around like awnings. Me and my people linking in the park like crawling. Things seem rocky.
Oh shit.
Drago Ivan. No cash broke bad, so damn high sent. Berg.
Duh. He said, now everybody trying to hang around me, like everybody wants to come around now that I found the success, like awnings, like literally awnings hang over you. Me and my people linking in the park like crawling, dog. Like literally linking, like we're meeting up in the park, but linking like Linkin Park, the group that the rock group that their debut song was Crawling. R.I.P. Chester Bennington. Dope wordplay. And then he said things seem rocky, like Linkin Park is a rock group, but Rocky, Drago, Ivan, who are like the people that Rocky fought against in the movies. Dog, the wordplay's crazy.
Things seem rocky. Drago Ivan, no cash, broke bad, so damn Heisen. Bird check the chemistry, I found this hybrid. It's Dilla in the pocket, but it's so Paul Simon.
Bro, he's so fucking nuts with the pen, dog. He said things were rocky, I got no cash, broke bad, like Heisenberg. Like Heisenberg, Breaking Bad, like, but he's broke bad. Like, no money. And then he said, I found this hybrid, which automatically goes back to Linkin Park, where the song Crawling was on the album Hybrid Theory. And he said, it's J Dilla, R.I.P., like, with Paul Simon, like the hybrid of the two sounds together. It's clean, dog.
In the pocket, but it's so Paul Simon. It took a little while for your mind to find it. But once you see the genius, it's intimidating, isn't it? Isn't it? Took a little while for your mind to find it. But once you saw the genius, it's intimidating, isn't it?
I think, if I'm not mistaken, that's Black Keys, because that doesn't sound like John.
But once you saw the genius, it's intimidating, isn't it?
This whole breakdown right here, it sounds like 21 Pilots. Like, not in terms of the lyricism, not what he's talking about potentially, because I don't think I've ever heard 21 Pilots talk about like that at a listen. He's not gonna be anything because he didn't have no attention span, but just the sonics of the breakdown and the way he put like stacks and layers his vocals, it sounds definitely like 21 Pilots.
Hearing things, but now they realize. Dreams that I wrote down, they came to life. I'm glad I lived my life preoccupied.
Holy fuck, dog. That shit was fire right there. He said they used to say that I didn't have an attention span. They used to say that I'm like lost in my own world, in my own mind, like over here, like in right field, no one, like way, way not in line with what everybody else is doing. But because I had all that shit that was going on in my mind, because I saw this vision for myself, now I'm glad that I was preoccupied with what was going on in my mind. Because if I wasn't preoccupied, I would have never found this career path that I did. I would have never shown the people the genius that is inside, especially in terms of music. The dreams that I wrote down, the things that I saw for myself that no one else believed in, I preoccupied myself with those, trying to make those visions become a reality, speak it into existence. And I'm glad that I was preoccupied. That's dope. But that transition from like that breakdown to from that bridge, whatever the hell you want to call it, into that drop of the beat, that was fire.
I'm glad I lived my life preoccupied.
Dope, dog.
Okay.
Nah, I don't need that shit. I don't need no drugs. I'm a fucking full-blown genius. My mind is already unlocked. The potential's been unlocked without all that bullshit. And not only does he say I'm a genius, which lends itself to the preoccupied line and being misunderstood as a child before, because a lot of geniuses are misunderstood, but he says I'm a full-blown genius. Get that bad. What do I need coke for? Like the nickname for, or like the slang term for cocaine is blow. So I'm a full-blown genius. I don't even need the coke. That's dope.
God made me a full-blown genius. What the fuck I need coke for? Outkast raised me. Lupe changed me. Hey. Now I do things with words to make you lames praise me. Whether Luke Kang or Luke James or Usain maybe. Ooh. Feeling flyer than a jet, son. I'm oh so spacely.
Feeling flyer than a jet, son? Like jet, comma, son? Like calling you son? The slang term, like son, like bro? Flyer than a jet. Airplane jet, Jetson, I'm so spacely. Like the Jetsons, the family. Me, George, Jetson, his boy, Elroy. Some of the kids out here that are watching this might be way too fucking young to even remember that show. That shit's on Boomerang now. But he said Outkast raised me like that hood Southern rap raised me, but Lupe changed me. He taught me that I could be a lyricist and I can have swag and I can be cool. Cause Lupe, when he came on the game, bro, when he came in with Cook Push, that was nothing unlike that no one has even heard before. It was a whole new sound of just suave, really cool, really smooth delivery. The dude is just too smooth with it. And he said whether Liu Kang, the Mortal Kombat character, or Luke James, the singer, or even Hussein, maybe Hussein Bolt.
Be feeling flyer than a jet, son. I'm oh so spacely. Now everybody clueless how to flow so crazy. Got me dashing with an actress looking oh so Stacy. I hate rappers.
Got me dashing with an actress looking oh so Stacy. Just that wordplay, dog. When he says that, got me dashing with an actress oh so Stacy. Like literally, like I'm in the coupe with a chick, with a fine actress. But Stacey Dash is an actress who had a role in the movie Clueless. And right before that line, he said, "Now everybody clueless, why the flow so crazy, crazy dog."
Got me dashing with an actress looking oh so Stacey. Ooh. I hate rappers, and I really mean it. Trying to ball with the kid to get you sun like Phoenix. Rather ball you up feather than tart until you're harder than sparring with Mayweather with leather Spaldings. This is my calling, so I answer.
Dog, got till I tar you with feathers like it's harder than Spalding with Mayweather wearing leather Spaldings, dog. Spalding the glove, but also tar you with feathers when he talks about like a phoenix. Try to ball with me, you'll get sun like phoenix. Like you try to play in my court, like you're not at this level of rapper, you're not at this level of artist. You try to ball at this level, I'll sun you. Like, and being sunned is a slang term for like, I don't even know how to explain sunned. I guess it's like when you embarrass somebody. Like somebody's stepping up to you that's not at your level, so you have to sun them. Like you got to put them in their place. But he says, ball, get you sun like phoenix. And then he goes right into the tar with feathers line like a phoenix, but also Phoenix Suns, the basketball team. Psh, dog. That's fire ass wordplay.
It's my calling, so I answer all with bars, but not for service. It's for hurting any person versus me. I've been rhyming since nursery.
Hold up. I was not ready for that versus purses nursery scheme.
Leather Spaldings. This is my calling, so I answer all with bars, but not for service. It's for hurting any person versus me. I've been rhyming since nurseries.
All right. I've been rhyming since nurseries, like I've been rhyming just since I was a baby, and I'm serving up these bars. Like this is my calling, like literally rapping this music shit is what I was meant for. This is my calling. So I'm serving up these bars, not for service, like bars, like literally like service bars on a phone. So I answer with the bars, but not for service, and it's not for hurting any person. It's just for hurting persons that verses, that like that try to go against me, that try to say that they're better than me. I gotta hurt them. I gotta sun them.
These third degree burns emerge from the furnace. Get close to me while I'm roasting. One of these pigs, my flow is rotisserie. It's a pity that all these
I'm roasting one of these pigs, my flow is rotisserie, like literally rotisserie, and the flow is so hot that he's roasting them.
Get close to me while I'm roasting one of these pigs, my flow is rotisserie. It's a pity that all these hoes slipping out of their hosieries won't get a hold of me. I slip through their fingers like rosaries. Been waiting for you to find it, so I leave it.
It's a pity that these hoes that are willing to come out of their hosieries, like come out of their panties, like they're willing to give it up. They'll never get a hold of me because I'm not doing it for that. Like, fuck these hoes. They'll never get a hold of me. I just keep slipping in their fingers like rosaries, like a Catholic, like a rosary, dog. Like you wear it, like let it slip through your fingers as you're doing the prayers of the rosary. It's fire.
Don't get a hold of me. I slip through their fingers like rosaries. Been waiting for you to find it, so I leave it where it's supposed to be. Because once you see the genius, it's intimidating, isn't it? Isn't it?
Fire. Isn't it?
Took a little while for your mind to find it. But once you see the genius, it's intimidating, isn't it? Isn't it? Isn't it?
No, but it's just like that swagger on the mic to know that they're going hard. Like it's intimidating how easy this is for me, isn't it? Like, it's okay. You can admit it. Like, I know what I'm bringing to the table. It's okay to say that you're intimidated by it.
Child or a fly.
It's that part right there when he says somewhat with a child or a fly, when the vocals separate. That's what reminds me of 21 Pilots for some reason. It reminds me of the end of Chlorine, and it doesn't sound anything like it. Like the topic of Chlorine at the end is powerful, but it just reminds me of like that transition from the song Chlorine into the section after the song is over.
But now they realize. Dreams that I wrote down, they came to life. Yeah.
glad I lived my life preoccupied.
That shit goes hard as fuck. Right as the most important line of the track comes out, and all the music stops and then drops in even harder. That's dope.
I'm glad I lived my life preoccupied.
Fire.
You need to get that bag out my face. Out my face. God made me a full blown genius. What the fuck I need coke for? You need to get that bag out my face. Out my face. God made me a full blown genius. What the fuck?
Beautiful mind.
Dog. Beautiful Mind, like the movie about the genius with the, who was it, Russell Crowe? I think he won best actor in a best lead actor in a movie. I think he won the Oscar. He beat out Denzel Washington in Training Day with the movie Beautiful Mind, which was about a genius. Was he schizophrenic? He had something going on where it was like, it was a dope ass acting performance. But yo, every time I hear a John Bellion song, I like want to listen to the whole catalog. I want to get into him, but I also know that y'all want me to make videos for him. So I can't listen to the music, or I can, and then it'd be a breakdown, but it's not as special. It's just not the same type of video. Y'all watching me see it for the first time and like, you know, catch up on all the things I normally catch on. But yo, this track is so dope. Like it's like light and airy and it's fun and it's like not heavy, but the hook or the pre-hook or whatever you call it right before when he says I'm glad I live my life preoccupied, like those eight bars, it's like heavy. It's like no one understood who I was when I was a kid, but I was always the person that I am now. I just had bigger dreams than you could ever realize. That's why you thought I was preoccupied, because I was, because I knew that I could be this. And then just the swagger in the verses for him and for Black Keys, like yo, the wordplay, the swag, the melodies, the way that they ride the beat, the way that they have the rhymes. Bro, everything about it was fire. But yo, that brings us to the end of this video, ladies and gentlemen. If you like what you see, please consider liking it. Leaving a comment down below helps the algorithm catch it and put it in the recommended section. And that's what helps the channel grow, when people click in the recommended section. Once again, Aaron, I really appreciate your request for John, because I know that y'all been fiending for him. So anybody that comes in here and requests him and allows the people to get what they've been wanting and more John reactions, that really means the world to me. I appreciate the money that you're willing to give on Patreon to become a member over there. Anybody else that wants to become a member of Patreon, like I said, to get a request in, or even at a lower tier, if you just want to help the channel and you believe in what I'm doing over here and how far the channel can go, Patreon is really what makes the channel push forward. Follow your boy on Instagram and on Twitter at The Third Earnest, just like the channel. Links are also in the description. Follow the Discord, or jump in the Discord, or subscribe to the Discord. I don't even know what it's called, but that is also in the description. If you want to talk to me, the Discord is the best place to do it. But that's all that I got for you today, ladies and gentlemen. I appreciate your time, and like I always say at the end of all of my videos, go out there in the world, love and care for one another, love and care for each other, and I'll catch everybody on the next video. Peace.